on the new bill. Mr. Deputy Chairman, today would be remembered as a great day, a great step taken for the consolidation of the unity of India, which was lacking.
Your only speech will go on.
And therefore, what I found surprisingly is the leader of the opposition doesn't seem to know the law. He says that Article 370 is the one that connects Jammu Kashmir to India. And he quotes Article 370. I will, Deputy Chairman, sir, quote what Article 370 says. Article 370 says the following, that number one, the provisions, this is Article 371, bracket C, the provisions of Article 1 and of this article shall apply in relation to the state of Jammu Kashmir. Now, Article 1 says that the name, union and its territory, the name and union of territory, that is Bharat, shall be union of states. And then it goes on to say and to see that the states and territories thereof shall be specified in the first schedule. And if you look at the first schedule, Jammu Kashmir is mentioned clearly there. So hence, Article 1 has the feature that once a part of India, it's part of the Union of India and therefore cannot be separated. That's why in Beruberi we had such a lot of problems when we couldn't give it away to Bangladesh even though it was a commitment made by us. Therefore, every inch of India which is part of the schedule is inalienable and cannot be removed. Then, what is the further it says, Article 370 itself, notwithstanding anything in the foregoing provisions of this article, the President may by public notification declare this article shall cease to be operative and shall or operative only partially. In other words, there is no mention of Parliament. There is no mention of a constitutional amendment. It says the President by a notification can remove Article 370, and which is what is now being proposed. And it further says that provided that the recommendation of the Constituent Assembly of the State of Jammu Kashmir shall be necessary before the President issues such notification. The Constituent Assembly of Jammu Kashmir concluded its proceedings in 1956. And what did they recommend? The preamble of the Jammu and Kashmir State Constitution says Jammu Kashmir shall be an inalienable part of India. India, Jammu Kashmir is an integral part of India, is there in the Jammu Kashmir Constitution. There is no mention of Article 370 in the Constitution. So therefore, what it appears to me is that the Congress Party leaders are totally ignorant of the law. They are unaware what the law actually says, and what we are proceeding now is on the basis of law. And bringing a resolution was an additional recognition that this should be informed to the Parliament. Hence, on this basis, I say that the Article 370 removal was overdue, and Article 370's headline is it's a temporary provision. Deputy Chairman, sir, Article 370, which protects our people from outside to come into Jammu Kashmir, died the day 500,000 Kashmiri Pandits were driven out. 500,000 Kashmiri residents who are called Pandits and Sikhs, they were driven out of Kashmir. And not one word has been said in their favor or any attempt to be made to have them return. How can you have Article 370 in a one-way direction? It cannot be, and therefore Article 370 has been violated repeatedly by the parties which were ruling all this time before the president's rule. I also say that what remains now for to be done is the resolution passed by Parliament unanimously that the portions of Kashmir in the name of Azad Kashmir with Pakistan, illegally occupied, they will be taken back. This is a resolution of this house, and it was unanimously passed during Narasimha Rao's period. And that is another thing that we need to do. And we also need to withdraw the petition filed by Jawaharlal Nehru in the United Nations Security Council, because it was done without the permission of the cabinet of Jawaharlal Nehru. I only say this, that the question of a temporary provision being removed, why are they objecting to it? They are objecting to it because of the fact that there is a vested interest in that. As long as 370 is there, other elements will take advantage of it. In fact, certain elements were encouraged recently by the fact that Imran Khan met the President of the United States, and the President of the United States mistakenly said that he is willing to mediate. There is nothing to mediate. 370 is gone. There is nothing to mediate. There is nothing to mediate except for Mr. Trump to tell Mr. Imran Khan to return the land which they illegally took from India, which is a part of Azad Kashmir. Return of the territory in the possession of Pakistan is the next agenda item for us, and I hope the decisiveness with the Prime Minister and the Home Minister has taken this step. He will take the next step also when we are ready to recover the land as per the resolution of the